Salut, c'est Mike pour le Views Magazine. Nous sommes donc ici avec Boris Breja qui va répondre aux questions de ses fans.
Bon salut, comment t'appelles-tu?
My name is Thomas.
Alors Thomas, tu as une question pour Boris Breja en anglais. Ta question c'est?
What's your best life memory?
Okay,
Yeah, I mean, I was like in Brazil like last month, and we were playing like on a festival, like was on the beach, and there was like a lot of sun, and it was directly on the seaside. So for me, I mean, to do a party on the beach with the sun, it's like the best life experience you can get. So this was like the best for me to play in Brazil on the beach with the sun. It was nice.
Hi, what's your name?
Jeremy.
Jeremy, you have a question for Boris Breja.
Exactly.
What's your question?
Sometimes you are a mask, sometimes you are not. Why?
Okay, that's a really good question. Thank you.
Well, you're welcome.
It's like a good question, but actually when I play, I use my mask like every time. And after like 1 hour of my set, then I put it off. I mean, like 2 years ago, I started to put the mask away because I was like bored of it, to use it every time. But then the people are getting angry. So I think when the people see the mask, then they know it's like Boris Breja. So I use it like for every gig, but like not the whole time, like 1 hour, and then I put it off.
Clara has a question in German.
Nice.
Yes. Wo siehst du dich in 10 Jahren?
Thank you.
Thank you too.
That's a hard question, man. Actually, I think it's not a good idea to think about where I am like in 10 years. I think the best thing is you're gonna live the moment, because now like the electronic music scene is like really big, and everybody is like going to parties, and you can play like every weekend, and I have a lot of time when I sit at home and make my music. So actually today it's like super nice, so I don't like to think about 10 years. I mean, I was thinking, okay, when I turn like 40, then maybe, okay, I don't get so many gigs in the future, because then you are old. And maybe it's better to stay at home and just make music. But actually, I think nobody knows, because life is changing so much. And just go with the flow, and then you're gonna see.
Hi, what's your name?
I'm Peter.
Peter, you've got a question for Boris Breja.
Yes, you've got a lot of gigs all around the world. What's the craziest?
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
You have like a lot of gigs around the world, that's true, yeah. And I think there are a lot of countries which are super nice. So for me, actually, when I play like in Brazil, or when I play in Amsterdam, or when I play in France, for me it's meanwhile like the craziest gigs you can have, because like the France people, I don't know, when you do party, they're just freaking out. So it's like super nice to play there. But of course, Belgium is also super nice. I mean, last year I played in Studio 22 here. Was amazing. Yeah, it was amazing, man. It was like super small, in the tunnel, but it was super nice, you know. Yeah. Really liked it.
So, Berlin is well known for its great nightlife, but as a German, which city could be an alternative?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's an easy question. Berlin is a super nice city for having the nightlife, and if you like to meet a lot of DJs, it's like the best way to go to Berlin. But in my opinion, I mean, I was playing like 4 times in Berlin the last 7 years. So for me, the opportunity would be like Munich, because in the south of Germany, you have like much more techno music. And in Berlin, it's like, it's like all about this house stuff, and it's not, yeah. Not the music I play, but it depends on him. So, I mean, Berlin is a good city, and Munich is a good city. I mean, Munich is more expensive, both cities are good. I would recommend both.
I also have a question.
Boris Brescia, Brescia, Breja.
Actually, it's like Brescia, but nobody is saying Brescia. Everybody is saying like Brescia, so I do it like the same. So it's like Brescia.
Okay, thank you.